My name is Vanessa. I was born and raised in Honduras. Growing up, we were always worried about money, how we were going to be able to pay the mortgage of our house. I also remember gathering around the table, eating dinner, not knowing what we were going to eat the next day. I think that the hardest part was going to school every day, knowing that at any point of time, my siblings and I were going to be kicked out of the classroom because tuition was never paid on time. When I was 6 years old, I was invited to church. I'd never been to church before. I had no idea what Sunday school was, but I was really excited to go. And in that particular time of my life, I was being abused. And going to church, meeting my Sunday school teacher, listening her talk about how Jesus cleaned 10 lepers, how he was the only one who didn't reject them, who loved them unconditionally, just like they were, that clicked something in my life. And I knew that I wanted to be part of this person called Jesus. It was a struggle for me to go to church because my dad didn't want me to have anything to do with religion. And every night I would go to bed and I'll ask God the same thing. Please let my mom and my dad come to church with me. Please let them know about this man named Jesus. And 2 years later, God answered that prayer through a very difficult situation. My dad was involved in a car accident. He broke his back in 5 parts. He was not going to be able to walk again. When a group of brothers and sisters from church knocked at our door and asked him if they could pray for him. And that afternoon, God completely healed him was a testimony of God's faithfulness. So when my dad saw what had happened, he couldn't deny that God healed him. And that's how they came to the Lord. When he told us, okay, we're going to go to church as a family, it was a joy, a miracle. One day, the pastor told us that they were having a surprise for the children. And I couldn't stop asking my parents, do you know what it is? I remember going to church, and the first thing that comes to my mind when I remember that day is a big red shiny box. We had a special service. They told us that inside that big box, there was a special present from Jesus to us. When they finally called my name, I ran as fast as I could, and I couldn't wait to open it. It was amazing. Everything inside the box was new and shiny and clean. Everything inside the box was mine. I remember having stickers and beautiful pencils. My favorite thing was this nice pair of fluffy pink socks. They felt wonderful on my feet. They were pink, they were not white. And when I looked at all those things, I was just so excited, and I kept asking my parents, who sent me this? Who knows that I loved all these things? Did you tell anyone that I wanted new pencils? Who did you tell that I wanted socks? And I remember they looking at me and they told me, Jesus. Jesus knew, and he sent you this box. And I literally thought, Jesus sent me the box. It gave me hope. It made me feel special. It reminded me how he loved me. And that shoebox represented the love that I thought I didn't deserve when I was 6 years old. God loves the children of the world. People who pack a shoebox are being an instrument used by God to deliver the gospel. That is the greatest gift. It might not look like a lot, but it means the world to us.